Omo ehye sikasem eswo eye Dr. Mark Esibe yeboa no no so akasa e de afa ho se ono so he kasa free edom kese no e famu ho e no ono so chese se working kai sa report na wo mo e de e ba ye no a na special prosecutor na adwuma na o ye no atosini
as a special prosecutor, or did he say that the public procurement authority didn't do their work well? I didn't read that from him. Eight firms put in applications, and two were shortlisted. I think Morgan Stanley and Imara have local partners. Morgan Stanley's local partner was Boulder, and Imara's was the data bank. That's the evidence adduced so far, and I haven't read anything to the contrary. Why? You don't determine who Imara wants to be their local partner. They have decided that Data Bank is going to be our local partner. Did we choose Boulders for Morgan Stanley? These are firms that have done business in the Ghanaian economy for years, and they have local partners they deal with. I haven't read anything from Matiami that suggests that there was some corrupt practice or there was something untoward in all of this transaction. You are a special prosecutor. You have to pronounce on this with definite that, yes, there was corruption, there was bid rigging, there was this. I haven't seen anything reported from the special prosecutor who says that the choice of Imara by PPA was corrupt. What he's saying, and which baffles my mind, is that Imara were paid in dollars, and to the extent that Data Bank is a local entity and there was no specification as to how Imara was going to reimburse Data Bank, then it means all of the flows Imara were inevitably going to end up. All of these are conjectures, hypothetics. They don't go anywhere. They won't stand in the court of law. Nowhere. They won't end up anywhere. I don't know. Look at what he has put together. He's doing a disservice to the country. So you are doing a corruption risk analysis. Assessment, if you like, in the end, now he's talking about who is government official one. Like, seriously, this is a corruption risk assessment on the Japa transaction. Mm. Read the report, and now he's talking about the EO group, what he's doing elsewhere. Then why didn't he give us an update on all the work that he's doing? I think he hasn't helped himself by putting out this horrible piece of work together for the approval process to start over. Parliament doesn't work that way. Ask my colleague in your studio. When Parliament pronounces on the matter, when a motion is carried, a resolution thereof, that is the end of the matter. If a fresh application comes, then Parliament will consider it. To all intents and purposes, the Japan deal is a closed chapter. If the president or the ministry or the government for that matter intends to bring a fresh matter, an improvement on whatever, then the Parliament will consider. Parliament cannot go back and say that we are going to reconsider this because the President says we should do. Maybe the presidency has intentions of resubmitting some additional information which we would consider, but I don't see this way anyway.